seven survived dedicated trees. And the fish traps are probably all mixed up amongst all the rocks there somewhere, but it'll be 40 degrees down there at the moment. Burn out feet walking around. Bank around the river, around the Darwin, the Barwon comes in downstream. See, didn't actually say what river it was. That wasn't actually a river. It's the Barwon River now. Lift up ridges. Birthday to Smokey. Probably just coming across the bridge that there. 400,000 kilometres. Now we're going to take it into the stormy, dusty weather across to Walgett. Oh, a night in a motel in Walgett. I escaped from the heat. All the shops were barred up. We had dinner over at the club down there. After starting to find the Chinese. There's our motel. We went to the wrong Chinese. But then life can be so...
What's it done? Turned off. Come on, I couldn't see it. I couldn't see anything in the thing.
Oh, it's white now.
I don't know.
Yeah,
when I picked it up, it was black. No, it was just black.
I think we missed the last bridge sign, and then just out of town, we've got this nice old railway bridge. I'm not sure whether it's abandoned. We're on this rush trip to Brisbane, always seem to be driving past lovely old bridges, not getting a chance to hop out and having a look and photograph them all. The railway line actually went, and then they had a stop sign on it, so it didn't go across the bridge. But I think it stopped just here because there's several large piles of silos of grain. It looks like they've got a bump of crop. It doesn't blow away in the dust storm.
Coming up to the Barwon. There's a nice homestead in there. I wonder if that gets flooded very often. Not a lot of water at the moment, unless the water's over further. Oh no, there it is. There's water in there. Wonder if they pump from the river for the homestead there. Wonder where the town water comes from.
just downstream from here. We're going to go up towards Moree, up past the Collarenebri, the home of the cod, which we were just up there. Just found a little track down to the river. Like a desert all the way from Walgett. Very dry, and there's dust storms sweeping over Sydney, although they're calling it not a dust storm, it's just fine dust haze. There's a little creek crossing, Yawn Creek. Looks like the creek's a bit...
Barwon.
Barwon. The River Red Gums, which flows into the Barwon. It's got water in it. They can water their lawns in the town because the cotton growers have stopped watering. So there's a bit of water for the fishermen and the townspeople. There's last year's crop.
Dusty. Lots of growth from last season though.
It's great.
Well, we're headed 4 or 5K off the road to a spot where it said cool or something, balloon lagoon and carved trees. We haven't found them, we found some big River Red Gum stumps and a dry lagoon. Looks like a good camp spot around here if you're into pig shooting. Oh, we found the sexy Collymongal carved trees. There's a few K back and then down another road, on the main road going north. But as usual, they ran out of signs. Here's your carved trees. I think I've got a book at home. Photographs of all these trees from this bore found. That was last used in 1890 near the river. Now they've removed them and from further away put them in this shed. They're actually all cut down. And about 82 and down to 73, and they went to museums, and a couple of live ones and dead ones, and they went to someone's garden and they went to a museum. And out in the bush, probably miles from where they used. And it's as dry as anything. Dry as all get up. There are crops in the neighbourhood over there. We've been driving through a lot of crops. This is all the black soil plain, so a week ago, we didn't pass the road. We went down to that lagoon. It's on gravel. Breezy and hot. Wait till Collarenebri when we saw this river again, and it's only a creek. Some of the creeks are rivers and this river is a creek. We're upstream from Collarenebri where it looked like just a creek. Here it's quite deep. I think some of the crops look like they had a seed crop where the rice wouldn't grow this year.
Probably change.
Or they do both. There's cotton fluff on the side of the road.
From last year, but no cotton on the...
Some mysterious weir. I'll have to look up on Google Earth. There's some of the huge dams or levee banks around the cotton area. And there's cotton on the sides of the road from probably a year ago. I don't think there's much cotton game this year. And a wallaby jumped off into the scrub. Here's one of the dry channels. We're going down to the weir. The big crop has been harvested. There's the weir, just downstream from the weir. Oh, no comment. Oh, this is a dry desert town of Moree. Not sure where they get their water for their green lawns.
Moree.
We are in Moree. It's very strange.
Moree's
just had a lecture about water from the man in the
Coles.
Servo, it's a pretty commercial bank. Yeah. I've been warned about the trucks today. They're apparently feral. All the hot weather's gone to their heads. Nobody's worried about the water table in where? New Guinea dropping and the trees dying. This looks like it might be the main river channel.
There's
the shag. The shag on the stick.
They're just looking for the way out of town.
Very beautiful crop that we don't know what is. Wondering whether it's sorghum or millet or something.
Miles off.
goes forever. It's been quite a long way along. And then up here, it's got silos and whatnots. And one of the grains. There's miles and miles of irrigated mercantile land now.
Our campground at Goondiwindi. Met a nice couple who were just here in this spot in an ultimate. A couple of bushwalkers who've done the lake walk and many other walks and camping trips around Australia. Might catch up with them on the internet. It's starting to warm up. Their own private billabong for their water, trying to keep the grass green. A bit of a battle in summer. I'll have breakfast now at 11:30 after our shopping. Public loo back in the middle of Goondiwindi. Victoria Hotel. There's lots of very bad looking dry prickly pear along the road. Chops up very easy with a sheath knife. It's going to flower a bit later. And on the right hand side of the road going north, it's fairly healthy, but on the other side it's pretty baggy. We're going north to Warwick.
Chris Evans accused Liberal senators of just
a fossil bird nest in amongst the galahs. All scattering in the heat. And I found a little spot for lunch. Well, we won't have lunch under the lovely river Red Gum. Oh, I had a nice lunch. Nearly trodden a water dragon just lying in the grass, lying doggo until I poked him with a stick. And the kestrels are feeding their young. And Helen just rang from first. And Terry and Helen are okay, and Terry's mum's still betting on the horses. She's written out her order of service. Make speeches. We're going off into Warwick. Was it Leslie Dam? But it's too windy. There we might go into Warwick. That's the third full dam or a quarter. So quite a large concrete dam. It's a bit windy for camping at the moment. Yeah, except the picnic site's nice
picnic
and sheltered.
This is sheltered.
Well, we stayed overnight in the caravan park after checking out three different dams. stay in. We toured around Warwick. Now we're going out to Goomburra, the main range, with it in rain in the this evening. It looks like it's raining now. Well, it's not rain. Into there is a campground, Goomburra, on the edge of a main range.
There's private four-wheel drive and campgrounds around here, the Gordon country. About a few miles, we're in the National Park campground. Mannum Ferry, which is in the Albury corner.